Now, in addition to acknowledging and commenting from here, from the Pi System Explorer, you can, of course, acknowledge and comment from the notification itself if you've configured the notification to include that information, you know, in the email. So let's take a look at our notification here. This is the one called monitored tags, or from the using the target called monitored tags. This was the one called MyNot1. There it is. And as you can see, I can easily acknowledge this from here. So I could just go ahead and click on acknowledge, and I can choose either to acknowledge or acknowledge with comment. So I'll go ahead and click on acknowledge now. The acknowledgement was accepted. Now, in this case, I chose simply acknowledge without a comment. So if I did want to do that, I could just choose this. Then you would have the option to put in a comment, and that would go in the same place we store all the rest of our comments. Now, that's kind of a short video. Not much to tell you about that. So let's just take this opportunity to go through and understand exactly all there is to know about this particular notification. If you recall it, we created it at the beginning called MyNote1, had a very specific trigger. We were looking for, you know, either of those situations to occur. And then depending on which occurred, we would use either that status or this status right here. Now for the content, you know, we did not add any specific content, although we could have added new things here. And this instant RT web parts trend is available as an option to include in the notification content. And that is because we do have an assigned Pi web parts server. Yeah, there's our Pi web parts server. So that's why that appears as an option. By the way, I'm not just being untidy here by showing you my email. These are the notifications that keep coming in to me as the administrator. So I've got some notifications that are firing all the time here. So that's what you're seeing here. These are the Pi notifications sending emails to me. Now, I set up a subscriber list that included the guy that I'm logged into on Outlook. I'm logged in as R. Wells, or Solution R. Wells. And as you can see, that particular subscriber has been provided that subject and this standard content. Now, I could have included the trigger input and the instant RT web parts trend, but I didn't in this case for that subscriber. I didn't in this case. And that's why you don't see those when you take a look at this notification. Now, you do see this acknowledge. And why is it we see the acknowledge? Well, it's because if you look at the options here, for here and the other email delivery channels, I chose the option to include the acknowledgement link if the standard content was chosen. That's a mistake. That's going to be changed to only with standard content. Standard input is incorrect there. Now, again, we could have specifically said yes or no, or just depending on what's been done for whether this includes standard content or not. And that's all about all there is to know about this. I triggered this by poking some values using the Pi system management tools, and I went into the archive editor to do that. Oh, and one last thing. If we take a look at this, I did decide that I wanted to show the details in the Pi System Explorer for the history, and that's why we're seeing these acknowledgments. That's why we're seeing these events have taken place. Let me go ahead and refresh this. Yeah, I could have hidden that, but I've decided to show this within this list. And we do that using this show contact events. So that's a summary of just about everything we've done in this notifications class with this sample.